Pollard up the middle. Touchdown, Carmi White County. Noah Pollard. Simmons is it. Carmi White County has done it. The Lady Bulldogs are sectional champs for the first time in school history. Left side, Edwards open for three. Got it. Carmi on top.
Fly ball to deep right center field. That ball is out of here. Caleb Seavers. A two-run home run.
Live from the downtown Carmi studio, it's the Saturday Morning Sports Show on 97.3 FM WRUL, 93.3 FM WROY, AM 1460, and online worldwide at WRUL.com. The Saturday Morning Sports Show is brought to you by Cherry Street Automotive, Citizens National Bank, Nancy J. Winter CPA, Hill Body Shop, Roark Transport, Farrell Hospital, Little Giant Grocery Outlet, Wabash Christian Therapy, Bush & Associates CPAs, Taylor Eye Care, People's National Bank, Hamilton Memorial Hospital, Rush Appliance, Wabash General Hospital, Carmi Lumber Company, Country Financial Rep Kyle Hosek, Pro Rehab Carmi, Rice Motor Company, Southern Illinois Trading and Supply, Expressway Ford, Jordan Funeral Group, First Mid Bank and Trust, Huck's Market, Invenergy, Jansen Auto Group, First Bank, and Carmi Kiwanis Club. Good morning and welcome to the Saturday Morning Sports Show here on 97.3 WRUL, 93.3 WROY, AM 1460, and online worldwide at WRUL.com. Cole Carter alongside Travis Black, J.C. Tinsley across the hallway getting us on the air. A lot to go over today and what's been a busy last couple of days in high school sports. Carmi White County getting a big win last night over Hamilton County, 44-33. We'll get into that. We'll get into some girls basketball action. EHT bracket came out. Other high school scores from last night. A lot to go over this morning. Also later on this afternoon, the Bulldog basketball team, they're at home again. They're going to take on the Benton Rangers. JV starts at 2. Varsity will tip off at around 3:30. You can watch and listen to the varsity game on 97.3 FM WRUL and the WRUL Sports YouTube channel. Well, Travis, big win last night for the Bulldogs, kind of what we expected. We'll hear what Kevin Wolf had to say. He wasn't too pleased with how the team played, and I think that's more of a credit to Hamilton County than it is a fault to Carmi, because when you play a team like that that's run and gun, full court press, a million miles an hour, they make you look kind of silly sometimes.
Yeah, that's the game you expected. Hamilton County all year has been full court pressure, whether it be man or that 1-2-2 zone trap press they like to run. And they did it last night, and they made Carmi look silly at times with some of the passes they were making. And Carmi, when they were breaking it early in the game, they were looking good against it. They got up at half, 25-13 at half, yep. And they did a really good job at breaking it, slowing it down. But then Hamilton County in that second half, they came out with some fire. Maybe it was that technical that Coach Doug Miller got in that end of the first half.
Which
there
was
that
awesome.
It was
awesome.
It's a textbook, one of those classic ones. You can write it down, you'll never forget it. But I think that might have just fired them up, because in that second half they came out and Carmi, you know, had 15 turnovers in that second half where they only had 7 in the first half, and some of them were just poor decisions on Carmi's part, and a lot of that is credit to Hamilton County's defense.
Yeah, and 15 turnovers in one half, that is very uncharacteristic for Carmi. You know, they just don't do that. You know, you talk about Carmi has had some teams where they struggle against full court press, and this is really the first team that Carmi has seen this year that has been all 32 minutes full court, not 90 feet, but the whole length of the floor. And Carmi had their struggles, but man, 22 turnovers on the night. That's something, you know, Carmi could see another one of those teams as early as, you know, here in a couple of weeks at the EHT. If they get into one of those big games, semifinal type atmosphere, you're going to face a team that's just athletic. When we saw Heron a couple of weeks ago at the Duke Coin Tip Off Classic, that is going to be up in your face the whole length of the floor.
Yeah, and you're going to see one of those teams, and you know, here in a couple hours too with Benton.
Yeah,
it's going to be a tough. They're going to play hard on defense. They're going to be up in your pressure. Yeah, and Carmi has done a good job at times this year handling that type of pressure and taking care of the basketball. And sometimes I feel like they just get a little lackadaisical, a little bit too careless with the ball, and that's where it's going to start to bite you. 22 turnovers in a game is just unacceptable, especially 15 in one half. You'd like to see more like, you know, 12 to between 12 and 14 turnovers is normally what this team is averaging in terms of turning the ball over in a game, because you're going to have some. Sometimes it's going to be, you know, just a little miscommunication here, maybe a bad pass there, but 15 in one half is just absolutely unacceptable.
Well, and I thought one of the few bright spots offensively for Carmine was Mitchell Edwards. Really good game from him, 24 points, a season high for him. And over the last couple of weeks, last couple of games, had a big game last Friday in the win against Florida. Go back to the last game of the Duke Coin Tip-Off Classic, had 20 points against Chester. And that's kind of what we expected. You know, we saw a couple of games where, you know, Mitchell couldn't get shots to go, and Gavin and Landon and Trey, Cade step up. But seeing Mitchell take over the way he has the last couple of games against a very good defensive squad like Hamilton County is very encouraging.
Yeah, you love to see that from him. I mean, he's a, you know, 3-year starter for a reason. He's very talented, you know, 6'7", 6'8", can shoot it like he can. And he was getting banged around last night. He was taking a lot of physical abuse, and Hamilton County had a man in his chest the whole time, and he did a good job at using screens and seeing when his opportunities were to, you know, get the ball going to the basket, or, you know, catch and shoot threes, which we know he can hit at a high percentage, you know, shooting 41% last year. So he's just got to look for his opportunities, because he's got to know everyone is focused on him. The central focus against Carmi, the defensive plan for the other team, is stopping him from doing the things he likes to do, which is, you know, catch and shoot threes, or maybe catch ball fake and taking a couple dribbles, getting going to the basket and just try to dunk over somebody. So, and he's got to understand that. He's got to pick his spots, and he did a good job last night at picking his spots and taking some of the abuse, because Hamilton County was bumping him every chance they got.
6'7", 6'8". Is that kind of how you were 6'4", 6'5" in high school? Mitchell's 6'6".
They have him listed as an easy 6'6", but he looks a little taller than that.
I think he's grown a little bit since last year.
I think he has.
Here is what Kevin Wolf had to say last night after the 44-33 win over Hamilton County.
Being joined by head coach Kevin Wolf, and coach, not always pretty, but a win is a win, especially in this conference against that scrappy ball club.
Yeah, we got the win. We played terrible. That's awful. Not good enough across the board. Defensively, offensively, just being engaged, very bad, yeah.
Hamilton County, you kind of knew what to expect with the style of play they've gone to this year, that full-court trap, and it put you guys in a lot of tough spots and had a hard time at times.
Yeah, their kids play really hard. We don't play hard. I mean, we're so Jekyll and Hyde. That's the phrase, right? Whenever you're up and down, and it's honestly, it's very tough. And I know that's my job to get these guys where it is. But it's really hard to coach this group right now because they're so up and down. And you know, you'll look good at floor. We played the best game we have all year. Shot it well. We're into it. That's a tough place to play. Come here at home, and it's all about a bunch of other stuff instead of just winning a basketball game. And it's tough. And these guys are gonna have to get it figured out. Like I say, we're gonna get beat by somebody that we shouldn't, and maybe multiple times.
Well, and you mentioned that the peak and valleys. You know, I thought there in the second quarter and early in the third quarter, you guys did a good job building that lead to, I think, 14-15 at one point, especially right at the start of the second half. But just things quickly turned, and they were able to get back in.
We don't run back, give up a layup, get beat to the bucket, should be up 15 or 17, now it's 9. You know, and then the guys start looking around, throw it away a couple times, now it's 5. And that's just how quick it can go, and these guys don't realize that. They just don't right now.
Well, you know, I thought Mitchell Edwards offensively, you know, when you guys need a spark, he did some things. 24 points for him tonight. And over the last couple of weeks, he has made some things happen offensively.
Yeah, he had some big boards for us. I hate whenever I sound like this to say that everybody who played was terrible, you know, not playing hard. It's just collectively. You just can see it. I mean, our fans can see it. I mean, I walked through the hallway and had two or three people in last game despite what it looked like. Everybody knows. It's not hard to see. But he played good. He had some big boards for us, kind of got in foul trouble, was able to finish the game without getting a foul. Man, we just did so many things that just not great tonight. I mean, how – panicking with the ball, launching the ball over the place. We've got two guards that have played for 3 years, and that's what's frustrating. I mean, get us into something. Settle the troops down whenever you're out there. I mean, we can't do it from the sidelines. We only got 5 timeouts. Just not good enough, and it looked very ugly. Credit to them, though. They rotate the guys in. They play really hard. I wish our guys played as hard as they do at times, because we don't, especially down at the defensive end. We'll have one guy doing it, maybe another, but not all 5. And it's frustrating right now, but we're talented, you know, so we're winning games. But the basketball doesn't look good.
Well, you guys have a short turnaround. Benton comes here tomorrow afternoon. A very tough ball club. They were in a nail biter with AJ last we heard, but what do we know about them?
Yeah, they're very good. Dr. Jack, or how the heck you say his last name, Docker, 6'7", can shoot it. Had 12 blocks the other night. He's, for those that will be here, he's one of the best shot blockers you'll see at the high school level. He doesn't put it into the stands. He just tips it, which then he gets it and gives it to his guards, Melvin and Billington?
Billington,
who can get out and go. The Munoz kid, shooting over 40% from the three. They're one of the best 2A teams in the South. So it'll be a test. Get him at home after a hard-fought game tonight. But if you think Hamco's pressure was tough, wait till you get Billington and Munoz and Melvin all up in you. And so it'll be tough for our guys. But, hey, I mean, all you can do is, I mean, we can't tell them, hey, back off. You know what I mean? We got to get better at it. And that just comes from valuing the ball, being in a triple threat position, have your eyes up, wanting the basketball, not being afraid of it. You just got to get the job done.
Well, and he's still got one more game before the holiday, but back on Wednesday was the EHT seed meeting. Yeah. You guys got the 3 seed. What are your thoughts on that?
Yeah, I mean, it's a good seed. And I told the guys in practice, I mean, they've earned it. You know, our Sparta win keeps looking better and better. Didn't know much about Sparta. Have never played them. They'd only played one game before we played them. They knocked off a 10-0 Trenton Westland team not too long ago. That was a good win early in the year at DuQuoin. Our Heron game, which was a 5-point game, was good. I like where we're seated. Got North City again. You know, I had the same convo a couple games ago. We didn't bring our best effort down there. And they're playing hard. They've won a couple maybe since then. I know they've won one since we played them. They're a young team getting better, so we'll have to, and it's at late at night. So these guys, I say it all the time, you got to find your own juice, you know, to get yourself ready to go and locked in. So we'll have to be able to do that for North City, and then you're probably going to play an El Dorado or an AJ. And AJ is no slouch. You're off to a little bit of a slow start. Like I said, playing with Benton, have everybody back but one kid. Really good squad from AJ. So it's going to be tough for us. Get the game out of the way tomorrow. I say it every year. We break the season up into kind of thirds. You know, the first third is getting before the EHT. And where we're at right now, I think we're 7-1 with a good test tomorrow. Regardless of tomorrow, that's a good start to the year. And then you want to take a break. You want to go to Christmas, have time with your family, and then it's EHT time, and then through the CIT, you need another good run. And then after the CIT, the home stretch, you need to finish off the year. So kind of pleased, but we can just play better. And the guys just you see so many good things from them. And then you just see a stretch of 4 minutes where they look like they have no idea what's going on. And I put a lot of that on me. You know what I mean? Like maybe I'm not doing something to get them ready. But, I mean, that was a run and jump press. I mean, you got to come back to the basketball when you're getting double, the guys open. I mean, we talk. Everybody knows what the heck I'm saying here. You just got to get the job done. And we didn't at times tonight.
All right, Coach. Thanks for your time. We'll talk to you tomorrow.
Appreciate it, fellas. Thanks.
That was Coach Wolf last night after the Bulldogs defeat Hamilton County 44-33. And Travis, you know there were some folks that got into the car driving home after the game and, you know, thinking, my gosh, Coach, you guys won the game. You know, cheer up. But we both played for Kevin. Yeah. We know Kevin very personally. And you know, I don't want to say he expects perfection, but, you know, when you got a team like this and the expectations are high, you're a yeah. 3 seed in this big tournament coming up. And granted, I don't think I don't think the effort wasn't there necessarily. Just I think, like I said earlier, I think it's more of a credit to Hamilton County than a fault to Carmine. But that's just me. What do you think?
I just think it was sometimes it was a little bit of mental lapse on Carmine's part. It's not necessarily the effort wasn't there. It was the focus that wasn't there. Yeah. Some passes, a couple times where, you know, Coach said it in that interview, you know, two guys who's played for 3 years, two point guards who's played for 3 years, and, you know, some of them are running away from the basketball at times. You know, you got to have those guys be able to step up and handle it. And they did a good job there towards the end of handling the basketball, handling the pressure, but you have to have that throughout the game. So it's not a lack of effort, it's just a lack of focus. And we've kind of seen that with, you know, the first couple games of the year, like the North City game. There's a little bit of lack of focus, not so much effort, just the focus wasn't there. And they have to have that against really good basketball teams like the one they're going to face here in a couple hours.
Well, we've talked a couple of times, even going back to last year, there was a handful of games over the situation. We saw it last night as well. Carmine got up. I think it was up to 15-14 at one point early in the third quarter. And again, you just get in that point, especially against a defensive team like Hamilton County, where you want to kill the clock, you know, take some time, burn the clock. You got the lead. You want to pick a knee, as one would say. But then again, you've got these high schoolers that want to score the basketball. And Travis, you know, as a coach as well, it is so hard to find that middle ground between, okay, let's sit here and hold the ball, but at the same time, you know, you can't grow your lead. All of a sudden, they get back in the game. That's what happened last night.
Yeah, you got to take your opportunities when they're there. You have to work for the open shot. And sometimes it's like, oh, I'm open here at the 3-point line. Let me just see if I can hit it. And, you know, when you're up 8 points with, you know, 4 minutes left, you know, earlier on in the game, that might be a really good shot, you know, wide open 3-pointer. But later on in the game, especially when it comes to crucial moments, you're up 7 or 8, and they, you know, made a little bit of run. If you're up 12, they make a run to cut it to 7 or 8, and they have the momentum. Taking that shot's probably not the best thing. It could be a momentum killer for them, but then it could also long rebound, run out, another layup. And that's what Coach Kevin Wolf was talking about. A couple of times that Carmine just seemed like getting back on defense wasn't their number one priority. A couple run-out layups that Hamilton County had off of, you know, a missed shot or a turnover. And those are the type of things that, you know, the team has to work through is, you know, keeping that focus, keeping that defensive effort, and then focusing on how we're running our offense, when people are open, you know, when to get people the ball. There's a couple times we kind of forced it in the paint when it wasn't there, and it was kind of a quick shot. When you're up six, you don't really have to force it in there. You can just work the ball around. And that's the difference between good teams and great teams. Great teams can run that, like, two, you know, there's in football, there's 2-minute offense. In basketball, you have a, you know, about 2 to 4 minute offense where you have something that keeps the ball moving, and you're still looking for a good shot, but you're not forcing anything. And at times we just, Carmine feels like they try to force things too much.
It's 4-minute offense in football. Two-minute offense is when you're trying to score.
Well, yeah.
4 minutes when you're trying to... I get what you're saying.
Yeah.
I just had to correct you on that.
Yeah, okay, football
but,
guy.
But again, the Bulldogs, it wasn't pretty, but a win is a win, especially in this conference. And as competitive as I think this conference is going to be this year, you'll take those wins. And, of course, Carmine will see Hamilton County again later on this year. I believe that game is in February towards the end of the season. They don't have a conference game again until, I believe, the first Friday after the EHT. I know they go to El Dorado, so that should be a good one. The chance they could see the Eagles in the EHT as well, that's never out of the possibility also. Scoring last night, scoring leaders for the Bulldogs, mentioned Mitchell Edwards, 24 points. Gavin Holloman had 11, 5 from Landon Driscoll, and 4 from Cade Stockton. You know, 11 points from Gavin Holloman. I thought Gavin did a good job being aggressive, going towards the basket last night. Starting to see a little bit more that from him this season.
Yeah, and he's doing a better job at, you know, being under control on those drives to the basket. Earlier in the year, he was kind of getting out of control and losing the ball and, you know, causing a couple turnovers from that. But he's done a better job at, you know, gathering himself, going up strong. And he's done a good job of getting to the free throw line doing that. And that can help alleviate some of that pressure off of Mitchell, where they're just not helping, and Gavin can get a lane going to the basket, and eventually they're going to have to slide off, and that'll open up Mitchell, that'll open up Landon. And that's what you kind of got to see from those two guards, Gavin and Mitchell driving, or Gavin and Landon driving to the basket, causing people to collapse, and then they'll start open up the outside shots.
So Carmine now 7-1 on the season. They are 2-0 in the Black Diamond Conference. The win last Friday over Floor and last night's win over Hamilton County. A non-conference game today, a game that's not really going to affect you one way or the other. You know, looking at the grand scheme of things, you know, this game against Benton today has in the past always been on Tuesday, but this year they move it to Saturday, and that could help Carmine. Said the Bulldogs don't play great today, and we look back to last year, it was a 30-point loss to Benton the day before the EHT seed meeting. Maybe had an effect on where Carmine landed, but to say Carmine has nothing to lose today, I think would be a bit of a stretch. I think if you're Carmine, a chance to prove something, because this is by far the best team they faced all year in the Benton Rangers today.
Yeah, this is a litmus test. This is the measuring stick. This is going to decide whether Carmine is a real contender and one of the best teams in Southern Illinois, or, you know, maybe a pretender in this case. It's all going to depend on the day. Now, it doesn't really matter. It's just going to affect your record. It's not going to matter for EHT seating, since those have already came out. It's not going to matter for conference. But this might be an opponent you might match up with in a regional. Might match up in a, you know, in a sectional situation. You never know. But this is one of the best teams in Southern Illinois for sure, and they got a bunch of guys back with a lot of varsity experience like Carmine, so it's going to be an interesting game to see today.
So they won't release the regional assignments and pairings until, that's not till I believe first week of February, but they did release regional sites and I believe sectional sites as well earlier this week. I don't know if you saw it, Travis. Do you know the two possible 2A regional sites Carmine could fall in? Do you look at that? Take a look at that. I'll let you take two guesses.
Take two guesses.
I will say both. Either one is a hefty drive.
Hefty drive. Massac?
That's one.
That's one. Lawrenceville?
Nope.
No, not that. North or south?
South.
South. Okay, hefty drive.
Southwest.
Southwest.
Guy Massac was one of them.
Vienna?
Not Vienna. West Frankfort.
West Frankfort.
So, West Frankfort or Massac County is the two regional possibilities.
My next guess was going to be AJ, so just for
AJ. I don't even know what AJ's gym looks like.
Yeah, well, at least we won't know about it yet.
But I've never been to West Frankfort's gym. I've seen pictures.
I've been there.
It's a cool-looking gym, a little bit older, the upper deck. So we'll see where Carmine falls. And again, that's a long ways from now. It's a long season. A lot can happen. But if Carmine wants to have a chance to be a top seed in that regional, it all starts today with a good effort and hopefully a win against a very talented Benton squad. Looking at other scores from last night around Southern Illinois in the 2A, 1A range, It was Harrisburg. How about a big upset win for the Bulldogs, defeating Massac County 64-51 on the road. Cameron Andy, 25 points in the win. What's the Hospin?
Isaac
Hospin. There's so many of them. I forget what his first name was. Isaac Hospin, 17 points. Harrisburg's won 5 straight. Massac has lost 4 straight. Harrisburg plays Carterville on Tuesday. Massac will play AJ and Heron next week before the EHT. So 3 really big matchups with those two teams coming up next week before the EHT begins. Speaking of Carterville, they lost to Gorville yesterday. Gorville, a 1A powerhouse year in, year out. They defeat Carterville 63-57. How about El Dorado defeating Flora on a half-court shot by Jake Phelps, 49-48. The final score there, Johnson City over Ziegler Royalton, 71-41. Benton was leading AJ 26-24 at the half. Rangers went on to win that one by 20, 59-39. So Ron Weinmiller got into his team at halftime, and they pulled away for the big 20-point win over an AJ team that Carmine could see in the second half of the El Dorado Holiday Tournament. We will get into everything EHT later on the show. We're also going to have our EHT preview show next Saturday morning. Jason Craig, Roger Hobbs, they're going to join me and Travis. Great to have Jason back in the broadcast booth this year, not only for the EHT, but for Bulldog Sports as well. Going to be a fun 3 days of basketball in El Dorado. We'll get to that later on the show. We'll take our first break of the day. When we come back, we will take a look at how the Bulldog wrestling team and the Lady Bulldog basketball team did this week. It's a Saturday morning sports show on 97.3 WRUL, 93.3 WROI, and AM 1460.
Whether you're a competitive athlete or want to enjoy a stroll around your neighborhood, orthopedic health is critical to your quality of life. The orthopedic and sports medicine team at Wabash General Hospital treats injuries and disorders of the bones, joints, ligaments, tendons, muscles, and spine so you can return to moving through life with greater comfort and ease. To schedule an appointment, call 618-263-6400. Wabash General Hospital, people you know, helping people you love.
Tax season is longer than 15 weeks here at Butch & Associates CPAs. It's all year round for us. We take great pride in keeping our clients in mind all 52 weeks of the year. We help our clients stay updated on all the IRS laws, changes, filing requirements, and deadline due dates. Please give Butch & Associates CPAs a call at 618-382-4151 or stop by at 113 East Main Street in Carmi, Illinois.
The Carmi Kiwanis Club is working hard to make a difference in the community, and it all starts with serving the children of the world. From fundraising efforts with proceeds going directly back into the community, to working hand-in-hand with the Key Club, schools, Arrows program, and much more. At the Carmi Kiwanis Club, we build, and we love to welcome you. We meet every Thursday at noon in the Wye County Farm Bureau basement. Come visit us for lunch, a great program, and learn more about how Carmi Kiwanis helps move our region forward.
Teamwork. Coming together is a beginning, keeping together is progress, and working together is success. Carmi Lumber celebrates the student athletes competing and wishes them great success. Depend on the team at Carmi Lumber for all success with your home projects. Electrical, plumbing, lumber, hardware, and more. Before you drive a nail, drive to Carmi Lumber. Visit them on North 3rd Street in Carmi or CarmiLumber.net. Carmi Lumber, proud supporter of area athletes.
Hello, Bulldog fans. This is Kyle Hosick with Country Financial. It's been great coming back to my hometown of Carmi, supporting our Bulldogs as well as my current and future clients. Whether you're looking for auto or home insurance, insurance for your business, life insurance, or a retirement plan, I can help. I take pride in quality customer service and promise to listen to what's important to you while ensuring you have the right coverages. Stop by my office to see what sets us apart. Country Financial Representative Kyle Hosick, 603 West Main in Carmi.
Ready for cold, snow, and ice?
Me either.
What about your car?
Ready or not, it's coming.
And now's the time to get ready.
Colder temps take their toll.
Heating systems, batteries, and tires all need special attention.
Winterize early and avoid a breakdown in the cold.
Visit Cherry Street Automotive in Carmi.
From oil changes to tire rotation, the pros will make sure your car is ready for winter.
Even if you aren't.
Cherry Street Automotive.
Your partners in automotive repair.
Call 618-382-7165 today.
That's 382-7165.
2165. Citizens National Bank of Albion has always been in the business of making dreams come true.
Are you like many in the community that have dreamed of owning your own business?
Bring your ideas in and speak to one of our commercial loan professionals in Albion, Olney, Crossville, and Bridgeport.
Our competitive rates and solid decision making will make it the best decision you've ever made.
Let us help you get started and we'll watch your business grow.
Citizens National Bank of Albion, no better banking.
Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
In 1925, when Farrell Hospital opened, they knew that families in El Dorado and the surrounding communities needed a hospital they could depend on, close to home. Over the years, Farrell grew to meet the needs of patients. Today, Farrell Hospital has grown to offer advanced emergency care, orthopedics, cancer, surgery, imaging, lab, and more, always keeping more care right here close to home. Farrell Hospital. You can depend on us.
Welcome back to the Saturday Morning Sports Show here on 97.3 WRUL, 93.3 WROY and AM 1460. Cole Carter alongside Travis Blank, J.C. Tinsley across the hallway getting us on the air. Again, later on today, the Bulldog basketball team taking on the Benton Rangers. JV will start at 2, varsity around 3:30. If you can't make it, catch all the action on WRUL 97.3, as well as the WRUL Sports YouTube channel. Travis, along with Jason Craig, will have all the action. I am hitting the road here in about an hour or so, heading up to Indianapolis to go watch my Pittsburgh Steelers play. Anybody who has seen the Steelers play the last 2 weeks are thinking, why would you do that to yourself? I don't know, but yeah. I'm going to, that's on my agenda for today. I was telling somebody, I bought those tickets to this game today, like 2 weeks ago. They beat the Bengals. They were looking really good, 7-4. I'm thinking, okay, Steelers are doing all right. We're getting things figured out. And then we lose two games in a row to two-win teams. So it's been a rough couple of weeks in the Carter household when it comes to football. But hoping that Money Mitch Trubisky can pull us to a win today against the Indianapolis Colts. So any Colts fans out there, best of luck to you. Should be a fun one. All right, looking at what has happened this past week for CWC winter sports teams. How about the Bulldog wrestling team? Last weekend on Saturday, they went up to Marion, or went down to Marion, I should say, for the Marion Duels Tournament. They got second place overall. Lost to Waterloo in the championship match. And for those that don't know, Waterloo is double the size of CWC. Terry Golson and his staff's done a great job. Numbers are huge this year for the wrestling team. And that's a big thing, Travis. You know, I know a lot of folks might not be up to date with wrestling and how that works, but when numbers is a huge thing, because you see a lot of these teams Carmi is playing and actually got them a win on Wednesday. We'll talk about that in a minute. But when you don't have to have 3, 4, 5 forfeits because you've got guys to fill in those and those spots, that is huge. Classes. When you've got a full team, full weight classes, which I believe Carmi does, they don't give away any forfeits. That's a huge difference maker, and that's Coach Golson and his staff, Chris Myers helping them out as well. I believe Scott Howard and those guys have been in it for a long time. They're able to get kids to buy in, yeah. and the wrestling team is as big as it's been since I can recall.
Yeah, they got plenty of numbers when you look up top, you know, and you see them running around, you know, trying.
It looks like a lot of fun.
It does look like a lot of fun. There's probably 50. It's close to 40 to 50 of them up there, and they all love it, and they all love participating. And it's a good thing where, you know, kids who don't want to go the basketball route or and then they don't have anything to do, it's a good thing for them to be able to participate in a sport during the winter, especially some football players that don't really like to play basketball, or, you know, track people or baseball people that don't have the opportunity, you know, because they don't really like to play basketball. But it's always good when you don't have to give up, you know, just free forfeits, you know, when they can fill out an entire weight class. And I've seen a lot of I've seen the one match they had against Mount Carmel, and I've seen a lot of their practices, and the kids are enjoying it. They're having fun, which is always good to see.
When I said it looks like fun, that was a bit sarcastic.
Kids that really enjoy it.
I say that as in, you know, if you've had the chance to go see what these kids –
I wouldn't say what Coach Golson puts them through, what they kind of have to go through in order to keep their weight and things like that. And it just, if you want to build some respect for some teenagers, because obviously, you know, Travis, I love eating me a cheeseburger every once in a while, and these kids that got to be strict and the workouts, and I tip my cap to those kids. I always say they're the hardest working kids in the school. They traveled to Robinson on Wednesday, won their match 45-42. Coach Golson talked to me after the match, and it was tied 42-42 after all the weight classes were over. And unlike the NFL, there can't be a tie in high school wrestling. So there's a list of criteria that they go through in order to find a winner. And the first criteria is whichever team received the most forfeits wins. Carmi had no forfeits. Robinson had two. And that gave Carmi the win. So we talk about numbers in wrestling, and it's a big thing. That alone got them the win in that big big match against a slightly bigger school in Robinson back on Wednesday. And that's, I always compare wrestling and tennis very similar here in Carmi, because not a lot of these small two-way schools have wrestling. You got to go up and play, like the Robinsons of the world, the Marions, Cartervilles, schools like that. And Carmi's been able to compete with them. They're 5-4 now in the year. They're going to travel down to travel up to Lawrenceville on Monday. So best of luck to Coach Golson and the Bulldog wrestlers. Then that will be their last match before Christmas break. The other winter sports team going on having action this winter is the CWC Lady Bulldog basketball team. Clinton Wolf and the Lady Bulldogs, talk about a great season. 10-1. They've matched their win total from last year, unbeaten in the conference right now. It's still early. They got a big two big games coming up Monday and Tuesday before they go into the Mary Mule tournament. Travis, we've watched them a couple of times, and man, seeing where they were last year at this time is seeing where they are now, and with a lot of the same girls that were playing back then, it's night and day how much this team has improved in the last 12 months.
Yeah, it's all that experience they gained from last year. They kind of took their lumps last year, and then, you know, some of them went from freshman to sophomore, sophomore to juniors, and, you know, two juniors going to be seniors, and they learned from their experiences of last year, and now they're one of the most experienced teams in terms of varsity experience around. And you can just see it. They matched their win total from last year before Christmas, and that's very rare. You see a 10-win team before Christmas. That's a testament to how much they improved from last year.
Lady Bulldogs went 2-0 this week. They've won 7 straight. They beat Mount Vernon 65-41. Mount Vernon, Indiana, that is, 65-41 back on Tuesday. They then beat Hardin County at home Thursday 70-22. So Lady Bulldogs, 10-1 on the year. If you haven't had a chance to go see them in person, they have 2 home games this upcoming week. They play a really good Mount Carmel team on Monday, and they'll host Evansville Bossy on Tuesday. So a fun way for them to end their first half of the season. And again, they will go into that Mary Mule tournament in Fairfield the same week as the El Dorado Holiday Tournament. Speaking of the EHT, the bracket came out on Wednesday, and we'll talk all about that after this, right here on the Saturday Morning Sports Show on 97.3 WRUL, 93.3 WROI, and AM 1460.
Hey, Bulldog fans, it's Luke Saylor with First Bank. First Bank is a proud supporter of Bulldog athletics and the community at large. For over 125 years, First Bank has been there for you then, now, and are well-positioned to continue serving you well into the future as we invest in our community. To show another way we are caring for Carmi, First Bank will donate $3 back to the Carmi school system for every Bulldog three-pointer this season. Together, we look forward to making great things happen for you, your business, and our community.
Housing lender, member FDIC.
2023 is almost over. That means it's time for Expressway Ford's year-end sales event. Like brand new 2023 F-150s starting at $36,990 plus 2.9% APR for 72 months. With special year-end pricing on all new F-150 crew cabs. Go to expressway ford online.com to see them. Expressway Ford, more Fords for less.
Excludes tax, title, license, and 225.2, 2.9 APR for 72 months through Ford Motor Credit, subject to credit approval. Tier 0-2, see dealer for details.
Great teamwork is no accident. And Hale Body Shop way out there on Possum Road in Carmi salutes all the athletes at Carmi White County High School. Just like in sports, the team at Hale Body Shop works together to make sure you get your car back as quickly as possible. When it comes to collision repair, more and more people choose the team way out there on Possum Road. Hale Body Shop in Carmi. David and the gang at Hale Body Shop are proud to be a part of this Carmi White County sports broadcast.
Hamilton Memorial Hospital Family Clinics are growing to meet the needs of White County. We're continuing to expand by welcoming nurse practitioner Catherine Worth to our Carmi Family Clinic location on Oak Street. Catherine provides a full range of family care, including women's and children's health care and minor injury care. Hamilton Memorial Hospital Family Clinics, the care you need when and where you need it, close to home. To schedule an appointment, call 618-382-5030.
What a hit! Now that's a playmaker.
With Hucks Bucks Big Rewards, you can be a playmaker too. Hi folks, I'm Chris Myers.
And I'm Cole Carter. Download the Hucks Bucks Big Rewards app now and save with great coupons on gas, snacks, and more.
And make sure to fuel up at the Bulldog Spirit Pump at Hucks. A portion of your fill-up goes to support Carmi White County Unit 5 schools.
And that makes you a playmaker in the community. Hucks Market, headquartered in Carmi.
The alarm sounds, coffee brews, and the porch light guides your steps toward another busy day. Just like you, Invenergy Solar is up with the sun. Invenergy's Boomtown Solar Project will create up to 400 construction jobs and create enough electricity to power 40,000 American homes. Invenergy expects to invest $60 million over the project's lifetime, helping illuminate the future of all in White County. Private investment developed on private property with public benefits. Invenergy.
Well, folks, that ain't country, but this is Skylar Harrelson from Jansen Auto in Carmi. It's been my pleasure to help my friends and neighbors get into the cars or trucks of their dreams for the last couple of years. Here at Jansen Auto, we're bringing you great vehicles at better than expected prices. There's really no reason to shop anywhere else. If we don't have it, we'll get it. All new vehicles are priced at huge discounts. Your hometown dealer, Jansen Auto Group in Carmi. Stop by and see why.
You can buy more of what you want when you save on what you need. Save on meal ingredients by shopping Little Giant Grocery Outlet in Carmi. Little Giant's team of buyers are constantly scanning wholesalers, looking for pantry favorites and meal ingredients at astonishing savings just so you can shop confidently, knowing that you can come in anytime and find great deals from fresh cuts of meat and grocery items to deli, fresh produce, and frozen goods. See just how much more your dollar buys at Little Giant Grocery, Carmi, Illinois.
Welcome back to the Saturday Morning Sports Show. Cole Carter alongside Travis Black. JC Tinsley across the hallway getting us on the air. We are just, 10 days away from the beginning of the El Dorado Holiday Tournament that will start on December 26th. You can catch all 26 games on 97.3 FM WRUL and the WRUL Sports YouTube channel. The bracket came out back on Wednesday. The top eight seeds and the eight unseeded teams getting matched. Travis, before we get into the top eight teams, well, I guess we'll go into the seeds, but, you know, the biggest surprise, I think, to a lot of people was Carmi getting the three seed. But if you go into records and everything, obviously Massac County, always talented. Vienna, very talented. Your top two teams, Carterville and Heron, but you know, Carmi fits right in there. They're now 7-1. You heard Coach Wolf say that Sparta win looks a lot better on them now. The big one over Floor, big one over Hamilton County. I think the Bulldogs earned that three seed, honestly.
Yeah, they were going to be a top five seed, and those top five could be interchangeable. You could put any team at any slot, and everyone would be like, okay, that's fair. But Carmi really did earn that three seed. You know, a couple nice wins. You know, the one loss they had was a good loss to a Heron team that, what are they? They're ranked two in this tournament. Yep. So they earned that three seed with a couple nice wins against Sparta, against Chester, and then the one loss they had was a really nice loss, 5-point loss to, you know, the two seed in the tournament. But all those top five teams could be interchangeable.
So the top eight seeds in this year's EHT mentioned Carterville number one, Heron number two, Carmi three, Massac County is number four, Vienna number five, and at Jonesboro number six, Fairfield number seven. They've kind of had a surprising hot start.
The Mules are the number 7 seed, and then Harrisburg mentioned their big win over Massac last night. They are the 8 seed. So Hamilton County is the technical 9 seed. They're going to play Harrisburg in the second game on the 26th. And, you know, Travis, I made the point to you last night before the game that I felt Hamilton County was coming to last night's game with something to prove. They were unseeded. A lot of folks were in the green, thought the Foxes should have been seeded. They were 7-2 when the bracket came out, 7-3 now. And I think they proved last night that they're definitely going to make some noise at the EHT, and they very well could pull an upset in their first game against Harrisburg, I think.
Yeah, no doubt about it. How hard that team plays, how much energy and effort they play with, and how well coached they are, they're definitely going to make some noise in this tournament. And it's really shocking that they were not seeded. I mean, I know they took a tough loss last week to Fairfield. You know, what was it, 21 points was the final.
Like that,
it was something like that. And that was their worst loss of the year. And I know strength of schedule early on in the year, they played a bunch of 1A schools that are kind of rebuilding at the moment. So their schedule doesn't look as impressive as other people's resume. But just the way, you know, the game film doesn't lie, and you just see how hard these kids play and how they run 10 guys in and out, and how much effort they play with. It's just incredible how hard they play.
So the schedule for the first day, Carterville gets the 1 seed, and they get the blessing of playing at 8:30 in the morning that first game. That's never fun. We'll talk about that next Saturday when Jason and Roger are here. But Travis, you recall, I believe it was our sophomore year, we got paired up in that 8:30 game, and Coach Wolfman is coming to practice at 8:30 sharp during Christmas break.
Yep.
And that's interesting. Obviously, Carterville playing the 16 seed Carrier Mills, they don't have to play their best game to win that game. But I remember last year, Harrisburg, Hamilton County, that 8-9 game was the 8:30 in the morning. You know, you're not used to playing that early, and it takes it's tough, yeah, to kind of get in the rhythm to play that early.
Yeah, it takes a lot to be able to get up that early and be able to play. Like, this is the only time of year you're ever going to play a game at 8:30 in the morning is the EHT time. I mean, yeah, DuCoin on Saturdays, what's their earliest game they'll play? About 10?
10, if
yeah,
that,
10.
Yeah.
So you're never going to play a game before 8:30 or at 8:30 other than the EHT. So it's kind of a once-a-year thing, and you got to be prepared and got to be ready. But, you know, Carterville gets the benefit of the doubt of playing a Carrier Mills team that is somewhat down this year.
I'm not saying 8:30 in the morning is early. You and me are teachers. Yeah. We get it. We're up at the crack of dawn.
Yeah.
I know a lot of
six thirty.
A lot of folks are home listening and get up probably 3:30 or 4:30 telling me to shut up. So we'll move on. All right. So 8:30 again, it's Carterville and Carrier Mills, the 1 seed and the 16 seed at 10 o'clock. Should be a good one on the first day. Number 8 seed Harrisburg against the number 9 seed Hamilton County Foxes. Winner of those two games will play on the 27th at 1:45. The loser of those two games got to play the Red Eye game that first night at 10 o'clock. Then at 11:30, it's the 4 seed Massac County against the 13 seed Hardin County. And then at 1:45, the 5 seed Vienna against the number 12 seed Edwards County. I haven't seen Edwards County play yet this year. I know they gave Gallatin County, actually I think they beat Gallatin, yeah, County in that Hamilton County Invitational Tournament. So intrigued to see how Edwards County has done this year. They were very young last year, so a lot of freshmen and sophomores who are now sophomores and juniors playing for Coach Schnicker and the Lions, so that could be an interesting matchup. We'll see if Edwards County can make that one interesting. And of course, the winner of those two games will play the 27th at 3:15. The loser of those two games play the 27th at 8:30 a.m. Then at 3:15, this one should be good, I think. Number 7, Fairfield against number 10, West Frankfort. Then at 4:45, number 2, Heron, and number 15, Gallatin County. Now, I'm not being a second homer here. You know, I do teach at Gallatin County. Love those kids. Gallatin's had a rough start to the year, just 2 wins so far. I don't think they should have been ranked lower than Norris City, but it's not very relevant. But I think if the Hawks can play like they're capable of playing, and you catch Heron, you know, snoozing, I'm not saying they can beat them. Heron obviously is the favorite to win this game by a lot. But I think Gallatin can give Heron a run for the money. We saw Heron and DuCoin. They're definitely not as unbeatable as they have been in years past. They've won it 2 years in a row. They're not 13 kids deep like they've been the last couple of years. They really only go 7 or 8. If the Hawks can play like they played in the first half against Carmi, they'll give Heron a run for their money. And that's just me. Call me crazy, but that's what I think.
Heron only goes this year about six, maybe seven deep. That we only saw six against Carmi, but some other games they've done seven. So get one or two kids in foul trouble. And Gallatin County played really well against Carmi in that first half. Shot it well, defended it well. And again, you can beat any team on any given day. And as long as they come ready to play, they're going to make it a game.
So again, Fairfield, West Frankfort, Heron, Gallatin. The winner of those two games play the 27th at 7 o'clock. The losers play the 27th at 10 a.m. Then at 7 o'clock on the first night, El Dorado, they are unseeded, playing the 6th seed Anna Jonesboro at 7 o'clock. Then at 8:30, the Bulldogs of CWC take on NCOE. You knew El Dorado was going to find some way to set it up to where they can A, play Carmi, or B, have a chance to win the consolation bracket. You know, they matched up with AJ. AJ has been a pretty decent squad this year. They brought back a lot from last year. They have a 1,000-point scorer on the roster, a kid that gave Carmi some fits last year in the postseason. But, Travis, if you look at the bottom side of the bracket, you know, if you're Carmi, a really good chance to bring home at least fourth place. And obviously, you know, you've got bigger things on your mind, but a potential matchup with Heron is there. You know, you're going to have to beat one of these really tough teams, but I think if Carmi can get that rhythm, it's been a while since, yeah, I think Carmi has performed well at the EHT. Last year, obviously, that tough loss to El Dorado in the second round. Go back 2 years ago, Bryce Connor gets hurt, they go 0-2. It's been probably since, you know, the third place year with Matt Rice, Jake Simon, Stubbs, those guys, that Carmi, I think, really, yeah, exceeded expectations in the EHT. If they can play like they're capable of playing, they can bring home some serious hardware.
Yeah, the way the bracket is set up, I mean, the toughest team is Heron. You won't face them till the semifinals if you get the chance. So you're going to match up with a North City team that gave Carmi fits, you know, last week against, or was it 2 weeks ago now? Yeah. It'll be the previous Tuesday. And they're going to play hard, so you can't take them lightly. And then you're matching up with either an AJ team or an El Dorado team, and both of those teams are physical, are going to play hard. So Carmi's got their work cut out for them, but they do have a great opportunity to take home some serious hardware.
Can't forget about our boys Devin Rankin and Casey Fulgerson hit some big threes against the Eagles a couple years ago, and yeah, pulling that upset, that was fun to watch. Yeah. But gotta love the EHT time. And again, Travis and I, Roger, Jason, we'll all break it down next Saturday morning, give you our predictions on who's going to take home first, third, fifth in the consolation. And again, all 26 games can be watched and listened to on WRUL and the WRUL Sports YouTube channel. We'll take our last break of the morning. When we come back, we will have our national sports segment with our Terrible 10 Pick'ems right here on the Saturday Morning Sports Show.
It's that time of year again. You're receiving all those pieces you need for your tax return. Every year, you resolve to do better, be more organized, plan better for your future. Now is the time to consult a professional. This is Nancy J. Winter, CPA, and I would love to help you with your tax return, but also with planning for your future, whether this be your farm, business, a new home, college, or retirement. Let me work with you to get the most out of your opportunities to achieve a better life for you and your family. Contact Nancy J. Winter, CPA, Cherry Street, Carmi.
There's only so much time in the day. That's why People's National Bank makes banking easy and convenient with PNB To Go mobile banking. PNB To Go allows you to deposit checks, pay bills, transfer money between accounts, view your statements, turn your debit card off and on, and much more, all on your smartphone. It truly is banking at your fingertips with PNB To Go mobile banking. People's National Bank, member FDIC.
Hi, I'm Jessica Cook, doctor of physical therapy with Pro Rehab in Carmi. Whether it's a twisted ankle, strained muscle, or knee injury that can make the pros gasp, at Pro Rehab, we have the playbook to get you off the bench and back in the game. We'll take the field of recovery together by developing a plan that maximizes your performance. Call me, Jessica Cook, for preventative care and post-injury rehab. 618-384-7872. That's 384-7872.
Roark Trucking and Roark Transport in Carmi. Driving the distance, delivering the difference. Commercial or residential. Anhydrous propane and fuel. Rock, dirt, and lime. Parking lots, driveways, and washouts. Farmers depend on Roark Trucking and Roark Transport to deliver their lime when and where they need it. Remember Roark Trucking and Roark Transport for your next job or your next haul. Fast and dependable. Call Roark Transport and Roark Trucking. 618-265-3665.
It's a Saturday Morning Sports Show on 97.3 WRUL, 93.3 WROI, and AM 1460, and online at WRUL.com. Again, the Bulldogs taking on Benton later on today at around 3:30. Travis and Jason Craig will have all the action there. Two girls games Monday and Tuesday. Both at home, Mount Carmel on Monday, Evansville-Bossie on Tuesday. We'll have both today and next week's games, both on radio and on the WRUL Sports YouTube channel. All right, Travis, before we wrap things up today, we'll look at our Terrible 10 pick'ems. And I made fun of you the first week because I whipped your butt, and you have come back, and we are all tied up at the overall records, both 18-12. You went 7-3 last week. I went 5-5. You pick an Army. That helped you. I picked Navy. And you got that one. I think I missed a couple of NFL picks as well. But lucky you.
I told you I was coming back. I had to give you a lead to chase you down.
Yeah, Philly playing like crap on Sunday night against the Cowboys. That didn't help either. But all right, we got five college basketball games, five NFL games. I've got some spreads attached here as well. I only wrote down five NFL games, so I'll pick one out of the wild when we get there. All right, five college basketball games all going on today, starting with possibly the game of the year. This is going to be played at Gainbridge Fieldhouse in Indianapolis. Number one, Arizona. At number three, Purdue. The Boilermakers are 1.5-point favorites. That's pretty much useless. Travis, who do you got here?
As much as I would like to pick Arizona, but I'm going to have to go with Purdue. I think Edie's going to take it over.
All right, I agree as well. Arizona, a big win last week when we had them on the Pick'em show. But Purdue picking up where they left off last year at the end of the regular season, number three rank, and I'm going to go with the Boilermakers as well. Number nine, UNC travels to Lexington to face Kentucky. The Wildcats are number 14. I'm going to go with the favorites in this one, which is UNC. They're 1.5 favorites. Kentucky lost to UNC Wilmington last week in probably won't pick them the rest of the year. I'm sorry, UK fans, but give me the Tar Heels here. Jason Craig would like that pick.
Yeah, I do not like that pick, but I'm gonna go with Kentucky just because they're at home and I would rather them win than UNC.
It's gonna be hard for you to pick UNC ever.
Yeah, ever. It bothers me,
Mr. Duke guy over here. All right, a local matchup. Evansville, they're on the road to take on Bellarmine. Aces have had a pretty hot start to the year. Pretty good campaign so far. Bellarmine is 2.5-point favorites. Who do you got here, Travis?
As much as I would like to go with the local Evansville, I'm going to have to go with Bellarmine.
All right. I think UV is going to pull the upset. I also just want to go against you here, so I'm going to take the Aces going on the road to defeat Bellarmine. Number six, Baylor. They travel to Michigan State. The Bears are 2.5-point favorites at East Lansing. I don't think the Spartans will pull off the upset. Give me Baylor.
Give me Baylor as well.
Right, both got Baylor. Can the Hoosiers pull off an upset today? They host number two, Kansas. The Jayhawks are 7.5-point favorites. I'm going to say no, the Hoosiers can't pull the upset here. Give me Kansas.
Give me Kansas as well. Okay. I would like the upset to happen just to see how things would shake out, but I think Kansas has it.
Didn't know if you were thinking about pulling the Hoosiers right there. All right, on to NFL games for tomorrow. A few games going on today. One of the ones I have on here is going on today. Let me find another random one for tomorrow. How about Bucks at the Packers? Packers with just a rough loss on Monday to the Giants. Buccaneers trying to hang in the division race. Packers trying to stay in the wild card race. Who do you got here, Travis?
Ooh. Oh. It's a Packers home
game. It's in Green Bay, which is a big difference.
Bucks haven't really played well for me this year. I'm gonna have to go with the Packers.
Yeah, I'm going Pack as well. Then they're going to bounce back. Jordan Love has looked pretty good the last couple of weeks. I will take Green Bay here. All right, this one is later on this afternoon. Actually, tonight's game in the Saturday Showcase 3 games going on today. Broncos at the Lions. Two teams right in the thick of the postseason race. Lions are 4.5-point favorites. Who do you got, Travis?
Broncos country, let's ride.
Really?
Devin Rankin and Bryce Northcutt would approve of this pick. I think the Lions will bounce back this week, but I think the Broncos are going to, still take it home. I think the Lions will have a bounce back game, but I don't think they're going to pull out the win.
Lions, a rough loss last week in Chicago. Ford Field's a tough place to play, though. I'm taking Detroit, getting the win over Denver today. Speaking of the Bears, they are on the road in Cleveland. The Bears somehow find themselves still in the playoff race. So are the Browns with elite Joe Flacco quarterbacking them. That Browns defense, that's what's keeping them in these ball games. Bears are playing really well. I want to pick Chicago here, but I think that Browns defense is going to be too much for Justin Fields and company. I'm going Cleveland. As much as I don't want to.
Yeah, I'm going to have to go Cleveland as well. The Browns defense is so good. And Joe Flacco last week, I picked him up in fantasy and I didn't even start him. He went up for 20 points.
Dang.
It always happens.
All right, this is going to be a good one tomorrow afternoon, I believe, or it might be the night game. It's 4:30 game tomorrow. Cowboys at the Bills. Bills are actually favorites to win this game. Who do you got, Travis?
The Bills are playing better. The Cowboys are right now playing like the best team in the NFL. I'm going to go with the Bills because it's at Buffalo, probably going to be on the colder side, and the Bills have to continue to win if they want any chance of making it in the playoffs.
I told myself for this one I was just going to pick the opposite of you because I can see this going either way. Bills are playing better after that tough losing streak they had, but the Cowboys looked very good last week in their win over the Eagles. I will take the Cowboys here. Tomorrow night, Trevor Lawrence and the Jacksonville Jaguars host the Lamar Jackson-led Baltimore Ravens. I want the Jags to win here to help the Steelers in the division race, but then again, I want the Ravens to win to help the Steelers in the wild card race. I will take the Ravens here on the road.
I'm going to have to take the Ravens as well. They're the better of the two teams, and I don't think Trevor Lawrence is 100% healed from that ankle injury, throwing three interceptions last week to go with three touchdowns, so at least it evens out, you know?
Yeah, that's true. That's all that matters, right? All right, there's our Terrible 10 pick'ems for this week. Travis will take a picture to make sure that I don't cheat on him or cheat on the result because I've never done that. I'm a very honest man and would never lie to you like that, Travis.
All right, sure.
Well, that's going to do it for us this morning. And again, I'm going to hit the road and head up to Indianapolis to watch my Steelers play. Might be a good thing, might be a bad thing. But Jason Craig will fill my shoes for the Bulldog basketball game today as they take on the Benton Rangers. That will be about a 3:30 varsity tip-off. And again, that game can be listened to on 97.3 WRUL and watched on the WRUL Sports YouTube channel. Big thanks to Chasey Tinsley across the hallway getting us on the air. For Travis Black, I'm Cole Carter. Thanks for listening to the Saturday Morning Sports Show on 97.3 WRUL and 93.3 WROY AM 1460.
It's that time of year again, cold and dark at 5 p.m. Hi folks, Nelson Ryder from Southern Illinois Trading and Supply, your local Skag and Spartan dealer, here to bring you some great news. We are now offering our winter service program for your machine. No aftermarket parts here. We use brand-specific products that keep your warranty intact. Just like Santa, we offer pickup and delivery. Call 380-2133 or stop by Southern Illinois Trading and Supply on East Main and Carmi to schedule your appointment today. Southern Illinois Trading and Supply wants to wish everyone a safe and happy holiday season.
Family owned and operated for more than 70 years, Rush Appliance and Furniture stands the test of time. We have a large selection of in-stock furniture and appliances for every room in your home, grills and smokers, and an unmatched dedication to superior service. This is Sean Rush inviting you to visit me in Fairfield or my dad, Terry, in Carmi, where we can help you furnish every room in your house with superb service after the sale.
Hi, this is Morgan DiMaggio with Taylor Eye Care on Falcon Avenue in Carmi. Here at Taylor Eye Care, we offer a full range of eye care services, including comprehensive vision and eye health examinations for all ages. Taylor Eye Care also carries over 500 eyeglass frames, as well as a large selection of sunglasses. At Taylor Eye Care, we treat every patient with the same care we would our own families. Call 382-4683 to schedule an appointment. That's 382-4683. Come see me and our fantastic staff to experience excellence in eye care.
Less stress, more family. Supportive living could be the answer. Personalized support with daily activities, social connection, and peace of mind for families. Just a few of the many benefits of supportive living at Wabash. If you're worried about mom or dad getting around, taking medication, or living safely on their own, supportive living at Wabash Christian Supportive Living could be the answer. Please visit us at chliving.org or call us at 618-900-8245 to learn more.